I'm Jason Shepard, and these are the fundamentals. What's happening, MzeroA Nation? Jason here, back in the fundamentals series, and sharing now about a neglected segment of the ACS. Ground reference maneuvers. Yet ground reference maneuvers serve us so well, not only in our landings, but our emergency procedures, our ability to divert our attention inside and outside of the cockpit as well. And I apologize for the construction. They're literally doing construction on this taxiway right here. But good videos never stop, despite them tearing up our taxiway. You can check the NOTAMs if you don't believe me. Anyways, with us diving into ground reference maneuvers, we're gonna head to the airplane here in just a second, and I'm gonna start with turns around a point. And turns around a point, the mission is simple. I want to maintain the same distance all the way around my point. I can show you with a great animation that our production team has made. And I can maintain that same distance all the way around the point based on where the wind is coming from. So turns around a point are all about where is the wind coming from and adjusting my bank angle accordingly. So that's great to understand ground track based for wind. But then there's a commercial pilot maneuver that many of you private pilots don't get an opportunity to practice. It's called eights on pylons. And the goal is similar. You want to maintain the same distance from your point, but you do it through something called altitude. It's actually our pivotal altitude. And what you need to do is you need to take your ground speed and actually square it. Now, if you're a miles per hour airplane like me, you take your ground speed squared, then divide it by 15. That gives you your pivotal altitude in miles per hour. If not, you could divide it by 11.3 to actually get that in knots. Now, you'll need to calculate two pivotal altitudes, a high and a low. So what's your slower ground speed based on what the wind is doing? For example, we'll be around 100 miles per hour or 670 feet is what our pivotal altitude calculates out to. And there's not a whole lot of wind today. About 110 miles per hour will be our faster when we have a tailwind, or 810 feet. So I'm going to bounce between these altitudes of 670 and 810, and I'm going to use pivotal altitude, just altitude, to maintain the same distance as I make a figure eight around my points. Think of it this way. Think of it like when you're a kid and you had that airplane on a string and you spin around, right? The faster you spin, well, the airplane kind of heads up there, right? But it's always the same distance. I slow down, the airplane descends, and it's a much bigger turn. Did the distance of you to the airplane ever change? No, it's attached to a string, but its altitude changed from high to low. Based on what? Based on how fast the airplane was actually traveling. And that's what pivotal altitude looks to show us through our eights on pylons. But enough of me rambling, enough of you hearing this construction, I apologize. Let's go where there's no construction. Let's head up to the air, and not very high in the air, just 670 feet. And let me show you first some turns around a point, a little higher than that, and then we'll go ahead and do our eights on pylons.
All right, MzeroA Nation, up in the plane now. Hopefully you enjoy that little ground brief and everything else. I found the coolest point for our turns around a point. There's a gentleman over here, or it could be a lady, I guess, having a bonfire. Hope they don't mind me running on their parade. But it actually perfectly illustrates where the wind is coming from. And obviously, the smoke is quite low, just over the treetop levels. So there's not much wind, but you can at least see which direction it's going. So we are going to do turns around a bonfire. Somebody bring the s'mores, I feel like. All right, I have got about my 800 feet. AGL is about where I want to be. Again, AGL, MSL, about the same thing out here. You'll be able to see this fire. I don't know how well you'll be able to see it from the cameras. Hopefully they capture it. One of them will capture it for sure. You'll see. If not, you'll see it around this turn and around this road. I have a tailwind right now. So we're going to do a quick turn around a point, and then we're going to show an eight on pylon, or eights on pylons, and then we will be done. All right, here comes our smoke. A beam my turn around a point, my smoke. 3, 2, 1, and put it right down. The only time I say I'll put my wingtip down on the smoke. Now, if you could see that smoke, I am now starting to be pushed away from my point. So what should I do with my bank angle? I should steepen it up a little bit. Now, there's not a ton of wind I'm dealing with today, but yes, I should steepen it up a little bit. I want to always be dividing my attention outside here, to my panel and outside in front of me. Always asking, am I creeping in on that point? Am I getting pushed away from that point and working through that? So right now, I'm at the steepest point of my turn around a point right here. Doing great on my altitude. Everything else is looking really, really solid. Bringing everything on around. Now, as I enter into the wind, with a little bit of wind coming over my nose, there's a big tendency to climb up and balloon up right here. We need to be mindful to not allow that to happen. So, I'm watching for that, keeping my point coming around here, staying nice and coordinated. Look at that, coming around, about to give you a really, really pretty sunset as we come around. And now I'm getting pushed towards my point. This is the shallowest portion of my turn around a point. As we take a look at that pretty little sunset there, and I shallow out my turn, and we enter all the way back around and complete our 360-degree turn around a point, diverting attention to three areas, out my window, at my panel, out in front, because there are towers, there are obstacles, there are issues out here that I need to always be mindful of and watching for. So let's discontinue. I'm going to bring us out over here, and I've already picked out two great points for our eights on pylons next. What is Ocala, Florida known for? Well, we are known for horses and horse tracks. And out here in front of me, I've got two horse tracks. I'm going to use dead center, just call the middle of each of these oval horse tracks out in front of you here, dead middle of those two horse tracks as my points. So I am working to come on through. I am going to split these two points here in the middle, and I am going to use my pivotal altitude, my highest point and my lowest point, as I work my way on around. So I'm entering right in between my two points. Again, just picture dead middle of these two tracks here. This one has a fence through it, which will be helpful. This one kind of has a retention pond in the middle of it, which will also be helpful. Okay, here we go. Dead through the middle of my two points. An area you get yourself in trouble is points too close or too far apart. These feel maybe a tad bit on the close side, but they'll be good. We roll into it here, and as we come on through, we are going to maintain the same distance all the way around our points by using what? By using our altitudes. So as I come around to this point now, what is actually happening? I'm going into the wind. I'm at my slowest actual point here. So where do I need to actually be? At my slowest actual point, right? Adjusting my altitude accordingly, just like we spoke about on the ground. Now as I come back around, I'm making those adjustments. I'm adjusting my pivotal altitude. In this case, I'm working my way on up, just like we saw on that animation, coming all the way around, initiating, working my way on through as I push towards that tailwind, right? We're coming up, adjusting our altitude accordingly for that, bring this point all the way around, picturing yourself like you're the airplane on the string, right? Hopefully that seeing that animation earlier helped you with that. I get back to cutting through, to making that perfect figure eight, back to roughly the altitude that I started at, as you can see here. Waiting for my next point, you should have about 5 seconds in between your points. That tells you your points are about right, and I'd say I talk a lot, but that was about 5 seconds. Eights on pylons this direction now. All right, working the wind back behind me now. So what am I doing? Where am I taking my pivotal altitude? I'm at my fastest speed, as you can see now. So I'm making my adjustments down and through. And then as I turn into a headwind, working towards my slowest possible speed and adjusting my pivotal altitude accordingly as that comes on through. And if you could see outside, I don't have a camera this direction, but we are maintaining the same distance all the way around our two points, again, as if we are an airplane on a string. Eights on pylons, perhaps one of my favorite ground reference maneuvers, because there's two points involved. It's a lot of back and forth around, a lot of moving the head, and it's so cool, discontinue here, it's so cool to see how we can use something like altitude, which I'm going to go gain some more right now. I'm not a big fan of flying down low just for fun. Climb back up. But it allows you to divert your attention inside and outside of the cockpit. Now you say, Jason, what? You've done episode one, episode two, episode three. You're wondering all these things, like, why are we doing all these things? I promise we're going to bring it all together here. We're actually going to put a nice ribbon on all this, too. On March 30th at 8 p.m. Eastern time, I want you to go to mzeroalive.com and get signed up to so I can get you in for our live stream. We're doing a live stream via Zoom this time, not the usual YouTube and Facebook. I want to see your smiling faces. So we're doing it via Zoom. Go to MzeroAlive.com to get registered for that. There's no charge for the event. Also go there if you want the recording. If you can't make it at that time for some reason, if you have family or work obligations, I understand completely. But go there and check that out. But MZero Nation, you are such a blessing to us. Again, as you're doing these flights, don't try to go do all this one flight. I want you to have at least 2-3 days between these flights, from the landing flight to the flight maneuvers to the basics, the ground reverse maneuvers. I want like 3 days in between each of these, a week most. So maybe you can stretch this out over a month, whatever that really takes for you to do. But I don't want you trying to do this all in one. That's the opposite of what we want. I want you to work to space these lessons out. So, MZero Nation, have a blessed, wonderful rest of your day. Can't wait to read your comments below this video on Facebook, on YouTube, on MZeroA.com. I enjoy reading those and read every single one of them. Have an amazing day, and most importantly, remember, the good pilot is always learning. Have a great day, everyone. We'll see you.